Bonjour mesdames et messieurs, in this video I'm going to show you a really cool trick where you can turn the CT lights on. Check it out. This is the before and magic. This is the after. I'm turning the CT lights on. Let me show you from the whole photo. I'm turning the CT lights on Place Vendôme in Paris. It's crazy. Let's get started. All right, bonjour, mesdames et messieurs. So, in this video, I'm going to show you a really cool trick that I use often when I want to turn the CT lights on. When I took a photo, it was quite the time that CT lights would turn on, and they did not really do it. So, let me show you how to do it. So, I'm going to go here on this virtual copy that I created here where there is nothing. And what's really cool in this technique is that you can, with one click, one slider, as I showed you, one slider, you can just turn off and on the intensity of the whole CT. Just like if you were at the city hall and you were turning the lights on. It's really cool. Okay, so before we get started, I just came up with an amazing book on Lightroom Classic called The 5 Steps to Natural Drama. It's 5 steps, which is exposure, white balance, refining colors, dodge and burn, and sharpening. And I'm gonna show you with like 4 or 5 different photos in this book. You can get the book with my masterclass. Check it out, the link is under the video. All right, so how do we do this? Well, first, a couple of tricks. When you zoom in, make sure you have you have 3 options here. Fit, then this one is 100%, which is kind of cool, and this one is like whatever you want. I usually put it at 300% or 200%, whatever I want to do. In this case, I'm going to put it at 200%, and I'm going to start at 100%. And then you can move around using the space bar. The hands become a little mouse, so you can move around. Okay, so let's do this lamps here. I'm going to go here, and I'm going to create a new radial gradient, okay? All right, so let's go here. I'm going to make a circle. Make sure you don't make the circle too big. It's going to be within the lamp, and I'm going to turn it on. And boom, I've turned on the lamp. I can even add a bit of yellow. But then the trick to put it everywhere is you got to, well, first let's rename this one. Let's rename this one lamps, okay? And then I'm going to right-click, duplicate radial gradient 1, which is this one, and I'm going to put it here. And I'm going to duplicate, and I'm going to put it here, okay? And this plaza has so many lamps. It took me about 20 minutes to do everything, so I'm not going to bore you with that. But I just want to show you a couple of tricks. You see these 2 lamps? They're stacked on each other, so I'm just doing 1 circle, maybe making it a bit smaller. It's very important that the circle be small. Don't make it too big like this. So you see now I want to zoom in more, so I can go at 200%, and I'm using the space bar to move around, and then I'm going to make this smaller. Voila, and duplicate this. Voila, there are 3 stacked on each other, no problem. And as I said, it took me a while to do this photo because there's so many lamps and beautiful lamps. If you get a chance, this is called the Place Vendôme. That's where the Ritz is in Paris. It's actually the most luxury place in Europe, and it's really cool. So I'm going to duplicate this. And one little trick I want to show you, when you go really far and the lamps starts to become really small, I can make this bigger, I can rotate this, and I can do all these lamps in 1 shot. Just make a small circle like this. And you keep on doing that. Once you've done all the lamps, you're not done. No, 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 sir. You're not done. Once you've done this, then we need to make a new mask. And this time I'm going to make a new radial circle. And this is going to be for the lights that these lamps create. So I'm going to make a big circle. And this time I'm going to go much less, just because a lamp would actually cast a bit of light on the floor. And this one, I'm going to name it light. And then I can right click, duplicate, and then I can make this go. So on this one, I'm going to make a lot less circle. Let me redo it again. So make sure you always duplicate the first one, because that way you can really decide, you know, how strong or not strong you want this to be. And you do that for all the photos. So at the end, what you're going to get is this result. Okay, and then it's really cool because, let me show you. I go here, and now I just got 2 masks. One is called lamps, lampadaire, which is lamps, and the other one is éclairage, which means light. So if I click on this one, I can just go here, make it, turn it off and on, you know, add some light if I want to, some yellow, and then, or I can go here, and this is the radiation of the lamp, like the, basically the light coming out, so I can make it big or small. And one thing I did is I made that photo a little darker so the light really would stand out. Pretty cool trick. Now, one more trick I want to show you. When you work with radial circle, you see a lot of pins there. You have four options. By default, it's on auto. Auto is really cool because when you're in a photo, you can select any of the pins and move them around. But if you go out of the photo, the pins disappear, okay? Now, you have another option, which is here, always. And in that case, wherever I go, the pins are on, which is really annoying. I never use that option. And then you have selected. Selected means that you only have one pin, which is the one that's being selected right now. Also very annoying. I never use it. And then you have never. Never is kind of cool. You can appreciate the photo without any pins. But honestly, I think auto is the best of best world because here I am in the photo, I'm out of the photo, I'm in the photo, I'm out of the photo, and I can appreciate, and I can turn off the lamps and turn off the lamp. Turn on, turn off, turn on the lamps. All right. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this. Get my book, Lightroom, The 5-Step to Natural Drama. I promise you it's going to change the way you retouch your RAW files. And I challenge you, look at the 5 different steps. It's a very specific workflow. And go back to your old RAW file and use that workflow to retouch your old RAW file. You will be surprised to what you can do with it. I'll see you in another video, mesdames and messieurs. Au revoir.